Good afternoon, dear students. Now, today we are starting our next chapter, which is test and measurement in sports. Now, so quickly we are just discuss about the content. So, in this chapter, we have covered motor fitness test. Second is in motor fitness test there are 8 categories. And keep in mind one thing, students, this motor test will also come for your practicals. It will also come in your practical. So read carefully, listen carefully, and prepare yourself. Although I am taking your physical practical classes, but still you will concentrate on the events. What are the events, what are the activities under this motor fitness test? Earlier it was AFR youth fitness test, now it was deleted, and it will now it has, now they have included motor fitness test in place of AFR youth fitness test. Some parameters are same as AFR, but some are changed. So we are discuss new 8 parameters of motor fitness test. First is 50 meter standing start or 50 meter dash. Second is 600 meter run, walk, sit, run and walk. Next is sit and reach test. Next, partial curl ups and push ups for boys and modified push ups for girls, standing broad jump and 4x10 meter shuttle run. So these are the parameters of motor fitness test. Next is general motor fitness test. General motor fitness, or we can called Barrow 3 item motor fitness test. Next is measurement of cardiovascular fitness. They have included 2 tests, Harvard step test and 1 mile Rockport test. Next is computation of fitness index, duration of the exercise in second. These are the how to compute your this I will tell you afterwards. And last is Rickley and Jones senior citizen test. Senior citizen test and Rickley and Jones is the same. So move on to our introduction part. We will discuss as a matter of fact, it is significant for individuals to set objectives which they want to fulfill in a physical education and sports program. It is also essential to determine whether or not the objectives have been achieved. For example, if you want to improve your cardiorespiratory fitness, you will have to participate in fitness program. After a certain period, if you do not measure and evaluate your cardiorespiratory fitness, you may remain in dark. Leonardo da Vinci has rightly said, if you are enamored to practice without scientific ways, you are just like a pilot who goes into a ship without rudder or compass and does not know his destination. So this is, that means whatever you are doing, you must have a proper knowledge about that task. test and measurement is physical education. In physical education are the instruments or devices for getting essential details regarding the needs, capacities, abilities, and attitude of student or sports person. So, through test and measurement, we are evaluate the student or individual's need, capacity, ability, attitude, etc. Tests are used to collect information or data about a specific skill. Tests are used to collect information or data about a specific skill, strength, endurance, knowledge, behavior, attitude, etc. In fact, test refer to any specific instrument, procedure or technique used by an administrator to result from the person who take the test. There are various type of tests such as Johnson basketball, sit and reach test, Harvard step test, Johnson basketball ability test, AFER youth fitness test, Cross Weber test, Harvard step test, sit and reach test, motor fitness test, general motor fitness test, Barrow 3-item motor fitness test, etc. So these are the crisp knowledge about test. Now, measurement are related to physical measurement such as height, size, weight, vital capacity, achievement, etc. Indeed, measurement referred to the process of administrating a test to obtain a quantitative data. It can also be said that measurement aids the evaluation process in which various tools and techniques are used in the collection of data. I repeat, measurement aid the evaluation process in which various tools and techniques are used in the collection of data. Through test and measurement, the effect of teaching or coaching can be determined. The process can be known and future planning can be made. Now we will discuss about the importance of test and measurement. First importance is it will help in selection of athlete. Next is individuals, game and classification of athlete. You can classify the athlete, you can give them suitable game or sport according to the individual. Thus, it will help to study the development of athlete. Through test and measurement, you can develop the athlete performance or his overall development, because through test and measurement you can know the exact position, exact performance of an athlete. So it will study the development of athlete, or whatever coaching, whatever training you are given to the athlete, it will be enough, or you will improve, or you will modify, or you will increase the intensity of the test. So you will come to know when you will take their test or taking their measurements. So it will help to study the development of athlete. Next is individually forced training program. So According to the individual, through test and measurement, you can give them or you can focus their training program. So that how the training is going on, you can modify it or you can make further training programs. It will help to motivate of an athlete. And that means if an athlete is doing 100 meter in 14 second, so you can motivate the athlete that you can do better if I am giving you, if you are doing the training properly, if you are changes your technique or your training program, so your performance will improve, your timing will improve. So you can motivate an athlete. Next is to predict in advance the performance potentials. If you are taking test and measurement of an athlete for particular games and sports, you can easily predict the advanced performance of the athlete, or you can easily identify this athlete can do better in the competition, or he has already qualified the parameters which are qualifying parameters for some national or international or Olympic games. So next is to prepare norms and standard. If you know the performance, if you know the result of an athlete by test and measurement, so you can prepare norms and standard accordingly for a team, for athlete, or for a performer, or any individual. To measure current fitness status, you can measure the current fitness status of an athlete. To conduct research, and accordingly you can conduct a research. And last is to achieve objective and goals. So accordingly you can achieve objective and goals for the athletes. So this is all about the importance of test and measurement. Now we will talk about motor fitness test. Motor fitness refers to the capability of an athlete to take part effectively in his or her particular sport. It can also be said that person's ability to do physical activities. The following test items to be measured. These test items are modified push-ups for girls, push-ups for boys, sit and reach test, standing broad jump, partial curl-ups, 4 into 100-meter shuttle run, 50-meter standing start, and 600-meter run and walk. So these are the tests which are conducted under motor fitness ability. Motor fitness refers to the capability of an athlete to take part effectively in his or her particular sports. It can be said that the motor fitness is the person's ability of the physical activities. Now we will taking the test and their administration. Now we will start our first test, which is modified push-ups. In modified push-ups, first we have to discuss about the purpose. Modified push-ups for girls, and it is to measure the upper body strength and endurance. By doing modified push-ups, we will measure the upper body strength and endurance of girls. Equipment required a mat and paper to record a basic information like age, gender, and push-ups performed. Now we will discuss about the procedure. The subject is asked to take starting position for modified push-ups. Hands and knees should be touched to the mat or floor. Both hands should be at shoulder width apart and elbow fully extended. The body from the knees to the hips and to the shoulders should be in straight line. While keeping this position, the subject should be lower her upper bodies so that elbow may be bent to 90 degree. Then the subject return back to the starting position. Now scoring. For the scoring, count of total number of modified push-ups for record. You can do the modified push-ups for 30 seconds and you will count the number of push-ups performed in 30 seconds. So modified push-ups for the girls. Now we will discuss push-ups for boys. First we will discuss about the purpose. To test or measure the upper body strength and endurance of boys. The purpose of push-ups is to test or measure the upper body strength and endurance of the boys. Equipment required: a floor mat and a paper to record basic information such as age, gender, and total number of push-ups performed. Procedure: after proper warming up, ask the subject to take position in a push-up position. Hands and toes should touch the mat or floor. Hands should be shoulder width apart. The upper body and legs should be in straight line. Elbows should be fully extended, keeping the back and knees straight. The subject lowers the upper body so that elbow may bend to 90 degree or chest may touch the mat or floor. Then return back to the starting position with the arm extended. And for scoring, count the total number of push-ups for record and perform this activity for 30 seconds. And then you will count the total number of push-ups performed by the boys. And keep in mind one thing, that it should be proper bending of elbows and extending of elbows while coming back. Then only one push-up will count. When you are going down and up, then one push-up will count. So the action will be proper for the same. Now we will discuss our third test, sit and reach test. The sit and reach test was first proposed by Wells and Dillon in 1952. This test is widely used as a normal test to assess flexibility. Now we will discuss the purpose of this test. The sit and reach test is a significant test to measure the flexibility of hip region including the lower back and hamstring muscles. So this test measures the flexibility of hip region including the lower back and hamstring muscles. Generally, it is noted that owing to the lack of flexibility in this region, there is a greater risk of injury. It is also entailed with lumbar lordosis and lower back pain. So we will discuss next, we will discuss about the equipment required. Sit and reach box or a mark sheet ruler, and a box may be used in which the zero mark can be adjusted for each individual according to their sitting reach level, because there is a variation of the length of individual's arm and legs. Now, procedure. First of all, shoes should be removed. Then sit down on the floor with legs stretched out straight ahead, or we can say long sitting position. The sole of the feet should be kept flat against the box. Both the knees should be locked and pressed flat. Kept flat against the box. Both the knees should be locked and pressed flat to the floor. Assistant may hold the knees down. Palm should be facing downwards. Hand should be on the top of the each other or side by side. The individual whose flexibility is to measured tries to extend his or her both hands forward along the measuring line on the box as far as he or she can extend. Now scoring. The score is recorded to the nearest centimeter or half inches based on the distance reached by the fingerprint of both the hands. I repeat, the score is recorded by the nearest centimeter or half inches based on the distance reached by the fingertip of the hands. Means first they have to touch normally without stretching. They have to touch the scale and then they have to stretch the hands, pushing up their body forward. And when there is they have to measure the initial touch and the extended touch. So that will be the score of the individual. The initial touch and the extended touch will be the score of the individual. So next is standing broad jump. The purpose is to measure explosive strength, power of legs. The takeoff line is marked on the ground. Equipment required: a sandy long jump pit and a measuring tape. So the procedure: a takeoff line is marked on the ground. Subject stands just behind the takeoff line with the feet several inches apart. The subject swings the arm and bends the knees to a jump in the long jump pit. Three trials are given to the subject. The distance is measured from the takeoff line to the heel or other part of the body that touches the ground nearest to the takeoff line. All jumps are measured and the best one is recorded. The measurement is noted in feet and inches. So, this is all about standing broad jump, or you can say standing long jump. Next is partial curl up. The purpose is to measure strength and endurance of abdominal muscles. So the purpose of the partial curl up is to measure strength and endurance of abdominal muscles. Equipment required: a flat, clean and cushioned surface, recording sheet and pen. Now, purpose: the student lie on the back with legs in flexed position, that is in bent knee position. His or her hand should be behind the neck. Elbow must touch the knees. While doing sit-up, the total number of repetition of sit-ups is noted in 1 minute only. Partial curl-up, or you can say sit-ups. If I am saying sit-ups, so you can recall the picture of sit-ups easily. And the scoring: record the total number of partial curl-ups. It should not be counted if the shoulders are not raised up properly by 2 in chest. Next is 4 into 10 meter shuttle run. Purpose is to measure agility. Equipment required: 2 wooden blocks, marker cones, measuring tape, stopwatch and a flat surface with 2 lines 10 meters apart, parallel lines 10 meters apart. 2 lines are marked on the ground 30 feet apart. The 2 blocks are placed behind one of the lines. The subject start the race behind the other line. On declaring start, the subject run to the blocks, pick one of them, run back to the starting line, place the box behind the line, run again back and pick the another one or second block which is carries back at the starting line. The time is noted down. 2 trials may be allowed and the best of 2 trials will be noted down. So this is all about 4 into 10 meter shuttle run. And next is 50 meter standing start or 50 meter dash. Purpose is to determine speed. Equipment required: measuring tape to marked track, 2 stopwatches. Now procedure: the subject take a starting position behind the starting line. The starter commands, "Are you ready?" and "Go." The word "go" is accompanied by a downward sweep of the starter's arm as a signal to the timer. 2 subject can run at the same time if there are 2 watches, 2 stopwatches. The subject runs at the same time if there are 2 stopwatches. The score is recorded in seconds to the nearest tenth of the second. So this is all about 50 meter standing start. Next, 600 meter run and walk. The purpose is to measure endurance. Equipment required: 600 meter track and stopwatch. Procedure: the subject takes the position of स्टैंडिंग राइट बिहाइंड द स्टार्टिंग लाइन एट द सिंगल ऑफ सिग्नल ऑफ रेडी एंड गो द सब्जेक्ट स्टार्ट्स रनिंग 600 मीटर स्टार्ट यार्ड डिस्टेंस ड्यूरिंग द कोर्स ऑफ रनिंग ही मे वॉक इन दिस टेस्ट मैनी स्टूडेंट्स कैन रन एट द सेम टाइम द टाइम इज रिकॉर्डेड इन मिनट्स एंड सेकेंड्स देर इज नो कंपल्शन ऑफ रनिंग ओनली द सब्जेक्ट इज द मेन पर्पज इज टू कंप्लीट द 600 मीटर रेस or distance by running or walking. This test is faced a number of criticism. Faced many criticism because it was related to performance related physical fitness test. Scoring is time is recorded in minutes and seconds. In this test many students can run at a time because the distance is more so it is not been a difficulty to measuring the time of the athlete or player because there may be a difference because of the distance and their timing will be recorded in minutes or in seconds. So this is all about motor fitness test.